Now then, it's time to make our move on the second airbase. This one right here. So I've moved the base over here. So we've got access to the bay around this way, so we can deploy the boat and stuff. We've got like an island here we can use for artillery. Now I did actually draw up a plan previously, which I've tried, I think, 5 times now to get going. Where I was dropping high command units both here and here, so we'd have like a staggered wave assault coming in. I would want the boat to be patrolling around the bay here as like close range anti-aircraft fire. I had like a couple of air batteries in the hills there, like I mentioned the mortars over here. And I was taking myself up there with a tank and a unit in an APC following it up. However, the high command units do not want to cooperate in the slightest. So, I'm gonna somehow have to try and find a way to do this within the confines of my own unit. Okay, now I want to recruit a mortar team. I accidentally recruited an AT team. So we want these guys here. I know that these guys do cooperate. And I also want to recruit... So if I go into Commander, recruit squad and AA team. There we are. So these guys all cooperate. They're fine. The issue that I've had is getting units to like actually move where I want them to go. So for example, it took me about, I don't know, half an hour to get one unit over to the other side. I had to change their waypoint to a mount waypoint, and that didn't work. So I tricked them into actually jumping into the vehicle by ordering them to do so, then getting their squad leader in. That didn't work because my Stavros would just take off. Then I had to assign the vehicle to the team so they would all get in. Then I went and dropped them over on the other side, and that actually did work, but the squad leader would not get out of the helicopter. I would manually get him out, return AI control, try and take off. He would just teleport into the co-pilot seat. That Ural's gonna sit there, so they're gonna be anti-aircraft fire to cover the base in case helicopters or planes fly over the top of it. Those resources there were from the AT team arriving back at base. This guy here, I'm actually going to temporary control and disassemble his mortar. We're just going to move that away from the flag, just so that the helicopter, when I get the helicopter out to sling load him, doesn't explode its rotors on the flag. So deploy the cargo ropes for single cargo and put them here. Like attach them to him. So the area I picked out was on this island here, just like in this clearing of houses. That place is actually forested over quite heavily, as you can see from the big mass of green. So I don't want him to shoot into trees and kill himself. So this clearing here is going to be the best spot, I think. Oh, I think I just brushed him along the ground there, but he's okay. I wonder what would happen if I dipped him in the drink. I imagine he'd die. His mortar would probably explode. I'm kind of curious, but I've tried this enough times now that I'm not going to risk complications. Alright, here we are. Let's drop all our speed and a bit of altitude so we can just, like, dunk him down. Like there. Release cargo. Let's get out of there. Nice quick drop. That's exactly what we want to see. Didn't clip my wings, so we're good. Let's RTB on that one. Oh yeah, also, can't go undercover in the current war level, where I'm like aggression 100, war level 9. So, yeah, we are way, way into the endgame now. Now, one thing I do want to test is apparently I can pick up the APCs if I use double cargo ropes and just fly directly upwards. So I'm going to try getting one of them out. I put it next to the helicopter. Double up my cargo ropes and see if I can just lift it. So if I recruit a... Ooh, let's see, let's get an AT guy and an engineer. Garage access. I have this Busk 3 into a 3, which I captured from one of the destroyer capture missions. So we'll put that down, like, here, I guess. Gonna have to drive it a bit closer. Okay, so Rossi, if I press 4, and the M2A3 get in as driver.
Driver, get into that vehicle.
Then Thanos 4, so I'm pressing 4 just like the regular number keys, so underneath the function keys, get in as gunner.
Gunner, get into that vehicle.
So I'm going to try and replicate what I was doing in, like, remember the Battle of Kavala from the previous season? Let's do triple cargo just to be safe. So pick up cargo rubs and attach. Oh, it literally gives me like 3 sets of cargo rubs. Okay. I see how this might actually... Wait, is it? Or am I just dragging the... Might just be dragging the same set of rubs, to be honest. No, it is literally 3 sets of cargo rubs, though I was dragging the same set. Yeah, you can see it kind of like pulled them back off. Hopefully this is going to work now then. Yeah, ideally what I want to recreate is what I did in the Battle of Kavala in the previous series. Only actually with the APCs moving. I think the easiest way to do that is going to be to have them in my own squad, because my own squad mates actually respond to my commands. So the instruction I was given on how to make this actually work was to apply full upward thrust from directly over the vehicle. So if I pull up now... No, it just can't lift it, it's way too heavy. I'm hoping though, that I am going to be able to order the APCs around. Now that was actually the bush on the left, not the flag, that destroyed my vehicle there. So, sure. That works, I guess.
Standing by.
Alright, so if I order my team to move here.
300 meters, back.
Roger.
Engine on and off they go, right away. That's so much more responsive than High Command is. Alright then, what other things do I have in the garage? Alright, I have a regular M2A3, so let's put that there. Alright. Let's move them back. Will they immediately respond to the command? Let's see, they've kind of stopped. That was the spot that the APC got stuck at before. Alright, so if I... Temporary control. Oh, apparently I was selecting a High Command unit at the same time. Maybe that's why they couldn't move.
Move 100 meters left.
Roger that.
No, they're stuck. I can just temporary control and move them back though, which is easy enough. And they do have the movement order right there. So if they get stuck, I'll just have to like manually move them one by one off the point. Okay, so now I want to recruit 2 more guys. I think I can have like a squad of 10 in total. Oh yeah, he's like actually obeying his movement order now. So let's get another engineer, another AT guy. But I didn't get an AT guy before, did I? I got an engineer and what was that? A sharpshooter or something? I don't know. Anyway. Kouris, get in the regular M2A3 as the driver.
Driver, get into that vehicle.
And then Leventis, get into the regular M2A3 as the gunner. Okay, there we go, that's my maximum, so I can see how many units I can recruit now. So I need one guy with me to be the tank commander. So that leaves 4, so I can put 2 more vehicles down if I have them. I have this, I guess. I can put some people in here. Okay, I only need the one unit with me, so I suppose I can put these guys into just these vehicles. So I get in the Musk 3 as the commander, that'll work.
Get into that vehicle.
And then the regular as commander.
Samaras, commander.
Alright then, so this one here is my vehicle, this is the tank. So I'll drop this. I'll jump in as driver and start the engine because it takes forever. And then Elias can jump into my vehicle as the gunner,
Elias,
not the gunner.
Gunner.
Get into my vehicle as the commander. There we go.
Get into that vehicle.
Oh yeah, we're all going. Everybody's moving. Alright, let's see how well this goes. People are getting stuck already. Maybe they're just getting in formation before they leave? Nah, that don't look like formation to me, I'm gonna be honest with you. But if I tell them to form a column with me, will they actually follow? This guy's following. There we go, this is what I wanted. Oh, that's perfect. Whoops. Yeah, they're all going. Oh, this is everything I could have dreamed of. No, never mind, they're turning around. Are they, like, changing order in the convoy or something? Wait, there we go, they're following now. So it just all depends on the position of the vehicle in front in the formation as to whether they're actually going to move or not, which is really annoying. There we go. Alright, hopefully we maintain this all the way around the island, because we have a ways to go. And having to drive past that outpost there might be a bit of a pain if everybody's stopping to try and shoot, so we'll just make them hold fire as well. We'll piss some smoke on them just for the fun of it. God, it took a year, but we finally have a vehicle convoy working as intended. Just don't use high command. That's the solution here. Don't use high command. It doesn't work. It's broken. It's bad. This is where it's at. Oh no, would you look at what we found? This might be a bit of an issue. I think we just lost somebody already. Oh, the gunner on the vehicle there, you know what, that's fine. As long as they're driving over those, we're alright. The only issue here is that's now going to bring a QRF in. Which is hopefully just going to be like a little bird or a UH-60. Otherwise that might be problematic. Alright, so the Humvee is now just a decoy, I suppose, to draw a bit of fire while the rest of us acquire targets. I believe we're now at the point where we want to turn over. I've held off going off-road for a while now because I'm just worried about them getting stuck on rocks and shit. So, I don't know, the Humvee seems to be working. The Basque is working. The non-Basque is about to turn off as well. Yeah, we're fine, okay. So we want everybody form wedge. So everybody's going to start branching out. Everybody's allowed to open fire. That's exactly what I was worried about. They've gone stuck. They've all stopped. Well, that worked, didn't it? Okay, return control. Then enters here. Temporary control. Just get him off that rock. Well, he wasn't even stuck on a rock anymore. He'd actually gotten himself out. Anyway, return control. Now everybody, form a wedge. Or not. Okay. Just move there. Okay. Wait, no, that's not what I want to do. I want to... God damn. I've requested 1E plus 009 rounds. Barrage. HE. From there to there. Sure, just fire 24 rounds on them. Oh, finally the vehicles are moving in. Taking fire. Alright, well, it's on. It's one down. The boys are actually going. I can only assume that the The Humvee's actually running people over. Here come the mortars. Alright. There we go, we've got more mortars landing. Let's get in the driver's seat. I think Antis is dead. Alright, everyone move up. There's a pilot up here somewhere, which means that they're moving to their vehicle. Oh yeah, there's one inside the AH-64 there, by the look of it. They are firing as well, they're like doing a proper job. Why is it only selecting Elias when I select everyone? There we go. Oh, it selects everybody in my vehicle and then the full team. It actually works, I suppose. It's not that bad of a design. Alright, I'm just gonna hit that gun. For the sake of it not biting us in the arse in a bit. Now getting 10 manpower as our taxes. Oh, getting hit by a mortar. Let's maybe move out of that. It's only HE, but we could do without that, to be honest. Oh, we've taken the airbase. Damn, that was quick. This really worked. The mortars are there, apparently. Oh yeah, I see him. Look at that. It's lots of HE. I think they're all dead already anyway. Oh no, they're not. Right here, okay. Now he's dead. Alright, back to the AT just in case. The boys did good today, didn't they? Damn. Alright, let's just hunt down the last of this infantry. Okay, the map contact there is dead. There's another one over this side. I think we're clear, to be honest. Let's just get Elias out of the tank. Yeah, we're clear. We wouldn't let us garage stuff otherwise. Alright then, let's get ourselves an attack helicopter in the garage. Look at that. A little bird sounds good too. Okay, that's all of that sorted. All the APCs are back away. I don't want the Humvee again, that seems like a bad idea. I'll take that UH-60. Maybe we can do this from, like, the air next time. That'd be interesting. Well, I'm going to stick around long enough to go down the bottom and garage up the rest of the vehicles. Then I'm going to head back to base and save before we lose this damn airbase again. I did have to, like, retake the other one immediately afterwards just because of that happening. Oh, we're finally going to, like, acknowledge that Antis is dead, are we? Alright. Sure. Well, that's the second airbase done anyway. How many more have we got? We've got one down there, two, three, four. I think this one's going to be the best one to do from the air. The one by the salt flats. Because we could take off from, like, down the bottom there, maybe? Or actually, no, we need to do it from another airbase. So if we take off the one by the lighthouse here, then we can do the airbase on the salt flats from the air.